All right.
My name is Amin.
All right, good. What do you do? What do you study?
Study for school.
Study, mashallah. What do you know about Islam? Explain me something. Do you pray?
Yes.
What do you pray?
5 times a day.
Okay, how many surahs do you remember?
I don't keep count.
Okay, say some surah. Go ahead.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wattuha wal-layli idha saja. Ma wadda'aka rabbuka wa ma qala. Walal akhiratu khayrun laka min al-ula. Walasawfa yu'tika rabbuka fatarda. Alam yajidka yatiman fa'awa. Fawajadaka dhalan fahada. Fawajadaka 'aynan fa'aghna. فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث.
Jazakallah. All right, you win. You can take some candy, whatever you like from here. Good, mashallah. Say subhanallah. Now explain me the meaning of that. Do you know the meaning of that? Do you know the meaning of that? Do you don't know? Exactly, that was my point. You know, I saw a video on a TV, on a YouTube actually, probably everybody knows the YouTube, right? So they were showing the video, one of the parrot, he was saying, Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, and the whole comments was saying, Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. I was like, what? What's so Subhanallah about that? It's nothing. He's a parrot, he probably be hearing the tilawa every morning, so he just memorized that. He's repeating. So this is the problem we have in our kids today. They don't know what they're reciting. That's the main point. You know, when you recite the Quran has to go here, not here. A child, you know how many children, millions of children memorize the Quran. Everybody agree with that? Millions of people, right? Even the elders and the kids, all of the kids memorize Quran. Thousands, thousands. When I make a kid like, come here, tell me something. You recite something. He says, okay, tell me what is it? I don't know. What do you mean, I don't know? You have to know what is that. That's the first responsibility of our teachers to concentrate on this thing. Because our teachers, they just make the kids to memorize, just memorize, 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 memorize. What are you memorizing? You know, a lot of people, I say they're making a prayer. They're saying, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Maliki. What are you doing? You know, we are standing before Allah. We are standing before Allah. That, you know, when we say like, Allahu Akbar, that means we are surrendering, we are just like forgiving everything for the sake of Allah, and now we are standing right before Allah. That means we leave the whole world behind, and we are just like concentrating on our prayer, and we are standing before our Lord to make up a prayer. And when I say, they're saying Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Malika, Yawmiddin, Iyaka Na'budu, what is this? So that's like they just memorize and they keep repeating in their mind. The prayer has to go here. You know, when we recite, it says in Surah Fatiha, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Oh my God, oh my Allah, I'm here to do prostration to you only, and you are the only one source of helper, source of sustainer, and you are the one who's been sustaining me. And why do we have a problem? We have a problem of our iman, because we just memorize that, and that's the problem. If we have a knowledge, but if we do not utilize the knowledge in a particular way, or we don't have a taqwa, and we are not like operating the knowledge in the right way according to the Islam, that's useless. I read the book in a Sahih Bukhari in the introduction, according to him on the Day of Judgment. It is just his opinion, it's not a fact. You say on the Day of Judgment, many people will come who have a knowledge and everything, and Allah will have the right throw his knowledge away. I say, you just have a knowledge, but you didn't use it. You don't know how to use it, you just memorized when you were a child. This is the problem we have. We just raised in our parents, in our families. That's the way we're raised. We just memorize and we keep repeating. But that's the problem we have it here, because we read the Quran here, but it doesn't go in our heart. If you go in our heart, then we will have a taqwa. You know, in the second chapter, it says in the first verse and the second and the third verse, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim, bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim, alif lam mim, zalikal kitabu la rayba fihi, hudallil muttaqin. This is the book of guidance, but for those people who have the muttaqi, who are the muttaqi people? Who has the taqwa? And what is taqwa? A shield. You have to have a shield over here. You have to know, you have to know what is wrong and what is wrong, what is right. You have to have a taqwa and you have to know how to fight with that. And you cannot fight with that until you have a connection with Allah. You cannot fight with that. You know, I remember the verse in chapter 7, Surah Al-Araf, from verse number 16 to 18, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rejected Iblis. What did Iblis told Allah? He said, فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَا أَقْعُدَنْ لَلُمْ سِرَاتَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ثُمَّ لَعَاتِيَنَّمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ إِيمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شِمَالِهِمْ وَلَا تَجَدُوا أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. He said, I'm going to attack everyone from the right, from the left, from the front, and from the back. He said, I'm going to attack from everywhere. Now who could answer me that? How are you going to survive? Who's going to answer?